EDP-445 is in jail? Now, you guys probably heard about this a little bit, but when I heard about this, I was like, dang, they finally got him? Well, that's the thing. So you guys probably remember EDP-445. Last year, the Predator Poachers conducted a sting operation where EDP essentially just admitted to meeting up with a underage girl for some cupcakes. And no, EDP-445 was probably not looking for cupcakes, but EDP-445 had a channel on YouTube that is now banned, actually, because essentially it got banned after all this stuff came out about EDP. But EDP-445 used to post really funny videos, and he was well known for being a really funny sports fan and just some of the outlandish content he was making.
Yeah, I just took a mean ass shit in Chipotle, and I've been holding this shit for almost, what, 15-16 hours, and I used so much tissue to wipe my ass with.
No.
When I flushed the toilet, it didn't go all the way the fuck down, so.
And ever since that sting operation happened, nobody was really talking about EDP anymore, and nobody had no clue what was going on with EDP. Nobody knew if, you know, EDP got arrested, or if he had any money, if he still had a place to live and he wasn't homeless, if he had a new job, since basically his internet profiles all got banned, therefore he couldn't make money off of the internet. But recently there's been a break in the case where this YouTuber who goes by the name of SunnyV2 uploaded a video called "A Huge New Update on EDP-445 from Bad to Worse." And basically in this video, SunnyV2 goes over EDP-445 and where he is right now and just some updates. And it turns out that EDP is actually homeless because he got evicted from his apartment by his landlord, because that landlord was actually being harassed by people because of EDP living in those apartments. And since EDP doesn't really have a form of revenue, like a source of income, he has been on the hunt for jobs, and he has been fired from a lot of his jobs that he tried to get because people would see him and then they would snitch, and then EDP would get fired essentially. And I believe that these people were doing a good job of getting EDP fired, and I think that they were doing the right thing, because I don't believe that EDP should be able to just run free and go on living scot-free from what he has done. Now, one thing he has tried doing to combat this is he has actually tried to change his name by applying for a name change, in which it does look like it was successful, because when you search up his name, Bryant Moreland, in the search, comes up with no results found, which most likely means that he is not known as Bryant Moreland anymore, which I believe this will be a little bit harder for people to find him exactly, but at the same time, like, the guy is super easy to identify. Like, if you just saw somebody who looked like EDP walking across the street, you'd be like, what the heck? It's EDP, because I don't really know anyone else who looks like EDP, and I believe he'll still be spotted. So he'll probably continually get fired from new jobs as people keep pointing him out to them, especially that now we know that EDP-445 changed his name and we know what he's doing. Now, I just wanted to talk about one more thing. The reason why this video was titled EDP-445 is in jail was because there were two sources that were saying EDP-445 had been arrested. One source being this YouTube channel that goes by the name of Matt Simon 818, where he basically says that EDP was arrested and has like no evidence of EDP even being arrested. So I find it very hard to believe that this information is credible. And actually, one of EDP's former friends, a guy named Felipe, made a video where he claimed that he got a call from a private number that was claiming that EDP-445 was being held at the Henderson, Nevada detention center, in which I have a hard time believing that this caller was actually the Henderson, Nevada detention center. And the reason why I say that is because anyone can call you and make their number basically say no caller ID, and then they can say, oh hey, it's the Henderson, Nevada detention center, you have a call waiting for you from Bryant Moreland. In which, as far as I know, this video was uploaded after EDP's name change, so that really wouldn't make much sense, would it? But besides that, to be honest, I believe that even if EDP is in jail or not, I believe that his life is a living hell, because the guy clearly has no freedom, or very little freedom, because there are always people following him and essentially getting him fired from his his jobs and getting him kicked out of hotels and stuff like that. And to be honest, in my opinion, I believe that if he did get arrested, he would probably actually like that, because then he wouldn't have to deal with all these people ruining his life and getting him fired from jobs and getting him kicked out of hotels and stuff like that. Because what he is going through right now just sounds like it's really hard. And if I were him, I would probably just try to go to prison, because they provide you with food. Sure, it's not good food, but at least you have food. Because, you know, EDP, he's homeless and he's almost out of money, and it's hard for him to get a job and keep it. But I don't know, that's just my thoughts and opinions on the whole EDP situation. If you guys have any thoughts or opinions, make sure you leave them down in the comments section down below. Make sure you like this video and subscribe. My name is Brion. Happy that EDP's life is hell, and peace out.